Hi everyone, I'm really excited today to take you all on a very different voyage beyond the Earth and towards the stars. But before we dive into the depths of our topic, I want to begin by posing a series of questions. Questions that gently nudge us to ponder the wonders of the universe. When you look at the night skies, have you ever wondered about the mysteries of the universe? Have you ever thought, are we alone in this universe? Are we the sole inhabitants of this vast universe? Or are there other life forms waiting to be discovered in some other stars? Have you ever thought that in our lifetime, we will ever meet an extraterrestrial life form? Do you think that this Earth will be here forever? We are currently enjoying the fruits of labor of our previous generations. Don't you think it's the responsibility of 7 billion of us down here to think of future generations? Isn't it space exploration necessary for the survival of human species in this universe? Is it possible to realize the journeys to the cosmic unknowns? Yes, possible only if we humans possess the technology for faster, efficient, and cheaper modes of travel. Welcome to the world of space propulsion that holds the key to humanity's interstellar future. Right now, we are on the cusp of emerging space technologies. Let's time travel back a little in history. From the dawn of time, humanity has been spellbound by the unfathomable depths of the universe, captivated by its boundless expanse and tantalizing mysteries. With the passage of time, our unquenchable curiosity and adventure have driven us to explore beyond the horizon, challenge the limits of what is known, and embark on epic journeys into the unknown. As we gazed up at the night sky and marveled at the twinkling stars, a burning question stirred within us: what lies beyond? When the human race wanted to defy gravity and explore more unknown frontiers, we discovered propulsion. Propulsion is about converting any form of energy into kinetic energy, which is the energy in motion. In space, we carried fuel and oxidizer and burned them, converting energy stored in the chemical bonds of the propellants to produce thrust. Tsiolkovsky put forth the famous rocket equation, wherein a body can move forward by shedding its mass. It's just like throwing stones off from a boat and the boat moves forward. And the energy for throwing the stones off can be derived from chemical propulsion. And then the Chinese rockets happened and Goddard came forth with his innovative invention of liquid rockets. The world changed forever. Space age has begun. We used chemical propulsion then in mighty rockets to take humans to moon in 1969. From there to the latest SpaceX Starliner mission, which offers us the possibility of interplanetary travel, we have always used different forms of chemical propellants to conquer gravity. We have used space-grade kerosene, we have used methane, we have used hydrogen. They were all tried and tested. Chemical propulsion was very powerful, but there's a catch. Let's pause there. Now let's shift our focus to the pale blue dot in this photo. That pale blue dot is our planet Earth. Suspended in the vast expanse of the cosmos, consisting of millions of stars, planets, and galaxies, our home. The Earth is the only home we have ever known. Within this tiny blue dot lies the entire history of humanity. Every laughter-filled triumph and tear-stained tragedy, every joy and sorrow, every achievement and loss, it's our shared home. And only known heaven for life in the expanse of space till now. That blue dot humbles us with its minuscule presence, a gentle reminder of our place in the grand expanse of cosmos and the fleeting nature of our existence within it. This famous picture was taken by Voyager 1 from 6 billion kilometers in 1990. Now, we have found out from Earth that there are exoplanets. Exoplanets are planets outside our solar system. We have discovered hundreds of them. Some of them are called super-Earths. They are larger and more massive than our planet, yet smaller than gas giants like Jupiter. They have rocky surfaces and have potential volcanic activity. They are within the habitable zones of distant stars, hinting at the possibility of extensive oceans or atmospheres and perhaps the presence of life. But they are still light years away. And how do we even get there? Now, let's go back to the chemical propulsion. I told you they are powerful. Yes, they are. And the catch is that the efficiency is low. You can think of it as a mileage of your car. That means we need to take huge quantities of fuel if we want to traverse the cosmos for explorations of this magnitude. Is there any other efficient propulsion system? Yes, there is. The answer lies here. Electric propulsion system. It is highly efficient, around 10 times that of chemical propulsion, which means we need to carry less fuel and the launch cost is significantly less. How does the system work? As the name says, it works on electrical energy. Normally, solar energy is harnessed and converted to electrical energy and used to create a plasma with a propellant. Inert gas propellants are conventionally used. Plasma is a fourth state of matter consisting of neutral atoms, ions, and electrons. This plasma is used to generate thrust by accelerating the charged particle, typically ions, to high velocities and expelling them out of the spacecraft. And instead of fire, smoke, and sound, its exhaust is a glowing, silent, and beautiful trail. And now, we have evolved from the fiery roars of chemical rockets to the silent whisper of electric propulsion. Currently, the thrust generated in electric propulsion is in millinewton and newton. In the vacuum of space, where friction is non-existent, the cumulative effect over time is profound and enables the spacecraft to gather momentum. Thus, a gentle but sustained thrust with remarkable fuel efficiency enables long-duration travels. But for faster space travel, we require kilonewtons of thrust. On one side, we have chemical propulsion in kilonewton, and on the other side, we have electric propulsion in millinewton and newton. Why the thrust is limited? Why can't we generate huge amounts of thrust in electric propulsion? The answer is power demand. Let me explain. Roughly 20 watt of power is required for generating 1 millinewton of thrust in electric propulsion. That means 20 kilowatt for 1 newton. For thrust in kilonewton, megawatts of power is required. Remember, we need to generate this order of power in space, and that puts the constraints. So, what's the solution? Here is it. Megawatts of power can only be generated in nuclear power plants. They have the highest power density, provide grid stability, and are ideal for efficient long-term operations. With nuclear power at our disposal, we have the capability to explore the farthest reaches of solar system and beyond. Small compact reactors with hundreds of megawatts are already realized on ground. They are hermetically sealed, maintenance-free, modular, have advanced safety features, and can work continuously for years together. But then, the challenge is to develop space-compatible reactors, and they offer a ray of hope for electric propulsion. What are the challenges? I have attempted to capture some of the key points. First, ensuring the safety and reliability of space nuclear reactors is paramount due to the potential for radioactive contamination. Designing robust safety systems to prevent accidents, mitigate risk, protect astronauts, spacecraft, and the environment from radiation exposure is essential. Second, launching nuclear materials into space is subject to strict regulatory frameworks and requires international cooperation and agreement. Third is complexity. Building a compact, lightweight, and reliable nuclear reactor for space applications can be technically challenging. Fourth, efficient thermal management. Managing heat generated by a space-compatible nuclear reactor is critical to prevent overheating, maintain operational efficiency, and ensure the life of spacecraft systems. Finally, the cost. Only cost-effective designs and efficient manufacturing processes can reduce the financial burden. Now, if there is a way by which no fuel needs to be carried and we can get it along the journey, won't that be fuel efficient and cost effective? Then, which is that fuel? The most abundant element in the universe is hydrogen, and it is a fundamental element in the universe. Intergalactic space is full of hydrogen. Stars are primarily formed from hydrogen, and new stars are born every second in the universe. If this hydrogen can be harnessed with proper collection mechanisms and electric hydrogen thrusters can be developed, then that would be the solution. Of course, it poses technological challenges. Now, if the thrust, power, and fuel are available in an efficient electric propulsion system, this system will be around 10 times more efficient than the chemical propulsion system and offer around 100 times the time duration. This can enable faster, long duration, and long distance missions. As the technology matures, nuclear electric propulsion with hydrogen can become very cost effective too and can open up new frontiers in space. This can be a solution to our intergalactic travel, and the boundless possibilities can ignite our imagination. Hence, as we come to the end of our journey together, I invite each one of you to take a moment to imagine. Imagine the possibilities of space travel that will enable us to cross the cosmos just like we crossed oceans on Earth. Imagine deep space robotic mission making scientific discoveries that can help humans on Earth. Imagine space and asteroid mining replenishing the Earth's resources from elsewhere, including precious metals. Imagine unraveling the stunning secrets of life with space archaeology. Did life really start on Earth or elsewhere? Imagine vacationing on other planets and staying in space hotels. Imagine getting the answer to the question, are we alone in this universe? Let us all carry forward the spirit of curiosity, wonder, and exploration. The universe is vast and our potential is limitless. With each question asked, each dream pursued, and each discovery made, we inch closer to unlocking the mysteries of the universe and of life. Thank you so much.